Dear Mom, I went to the little cafe yesterday with Anna to do some work. It was rainy and cold, and we had both been a little anxious of the end of the semester rearing its head at us. When we sat down at our table, we took out our computers, and over the tops of my own and hers, I looked Anna in the eye and asked if she was okay. We talked for a while then about how she couldn't sleep that night. She had been anxious and spoke to Georgie, who in her own right and way had been falling apart. The conversation brought with it so many things, as they often do, and she spent a while wondering that night if she was going to stop breathing. I told her I understood. She laughed. She knows how much I understand. I listened to her quietly and decidedly. In my head, I repeated, "Everything is okay. Everything is okay. Have faith in the okayness of everything." Hoping the vibrations of that voice inside me would somehow make its way to moving her. We worked for an hour after talking. She emailed a potential therapist, that was part of the little plan we had ended up devising, and I drafted out an essay on the experimental dance show I saw. At some point we shut our computers, and I told her about my night. I thought it might be light or even fun. Silly problems sometimes help. "I got a letter from Joey," I said. She had been up to date on the whole of our little drama so far. She knew we had been sending emails and that they ended after I sent my angry one. It had become too much to hold, and I told him that I had felt like he gave me something in telling me he had feelings for me, and then as I began to pick it up to turn it over to feel the weight of that thing in my hand, he ran, and I felt left. And I would never tell him, but the world was more exciting when we did it together. And to him, I took too long. Anyway, he wrote me an email in response. So I let Anna read it, and she got angry. "He's an ass," she said. "This is brutal." And I found myself defending him, but he's right. He's right about all of it, and I left him too. I was a coward, absolutely. And if that wasn't telling enough, I started to cry. I told her, he said maybe I liked the pain, the way I suffered in denying my feelings too. At this point, Anna grabbed my hand and held it. I told her he was wrong about that. There would be no excuse if I had him and he had me for me to be sad sometimes. And what if I couldn't bear that? I didn't like the pain. I was terrified. So through the tears I wasn't expecting and amidst the story I thought would lighten it all, and in our little bookshop that we had come to love so quickly, I said, "I'm so mad at him because I do not feel safe loving him, and I love him. And Mom, I don't know why it is, or if it has something to do with you or something old and hiding, but I do not often feel that I know how I am feeling. I feel terrified of certainty and adverse to decision, and I run from all of it. I called Jack that night. He was sick and lost his voice, so he listened as I spoke and texted me in response. "Hi, Jack. Hi. I'm crying. Just breathe." He told me that whatever I do next, make sure I'm sure. And with that, I felt flung to the beginning. I am sure of nothing and never have been. How to be sure of love, I told him. Then he clarified brilliantly. Being sure is just being mostly sure. Educated guesses, that's all life is. "I would like to trust myself, Mom. I would like to find a way to believe in my feelings, but also accept them changing. I would like to take pain seriously, but not indulge it. I would like to believe in love, but not fabricate it. I would like to not fake anything. I would like to be seen. I would like to be able to talk to Joey every day. I would like to be able to be alone, to write, to make, to breathe, to take all this little living in at once, but also unbelievably, incomprehensibly slowly. I would like to change, and I am changing. I am the only one that would look at all this evidence and still doubt it. But I'm not today, and I hope, if anything, that isn't momentary. It is hard for me sometimes to speak to you casually. I'm pretending while writing this that we are in a car together, alone, driving somewhere, and both of us have no reason to stop talking. There's more to say, but there always is. I love you, Lola."
Thank you.